know most of us are very, very tired. I'm tired myself. I'm yet to do my presentation, but I'm already tired. But it's been fun, and I've enjoyed every session. Now, before I start, when I was in primary school, I don't know how many of us have gone to the type of primary school I've gone to, but I'll find out very soon. There was this thing we used to recite. When you see a traffic light, something you must know. Red says, yellow means, green means, go, 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 and go. Okay. During that time, there was no traffic light in the town that I grew up. So it was just something we just, you know, we're just going about it and we're just enjoying it. Then I came to Accra. For the first few weeks and months, I always get confused when I get to the traffic light. Do you realize the traffic light doesn't move from red? It doesn't move from red to yellow to green. This is how the traffic light moves. It's from green, then get ready to stop, then stop. If you don't know, when you step out, you get to the nearest traffic light. Just watch it. So I was very confused. When I came to Accra, it was a little bit difficult trying to settle in a new environment like that. But that was the type of school I went to. And I'm very glad there's a lot of people here who went to that type of school. Now, when I was growing up, I was born in 1983. That was the year of the famine. There was a famine in Ghana. So this particular photo, this one, I was looking somewhere else. I didn't really know what I was looking at, but because of the famine, I was living very wild when I was very small. I was like, the photographer should just hurry up. Let me just go and do some other stuff. And when I was in primary school and during my junior high school levels, I used to have my own farmland. I'm not talking about a garden, like a big farmland. And I used to rear poultry. When I went to the secondary school, it was outside of my town, so I had to convert all my poultry into shito because there was no one to take care of them for me. And I stopped farming along the line too. Then I also realized that in my primary school and junior high school days, you know, this perception of you can't be a serious student and be chilling and be watching a lot of TV and be Facebooking and all that. In primary school, we fed that statement to the dogs. But when I got to the senior high and the university, I realized the dogs had a different taste. They didn't have taste for those type of things again. Now, what am I trying to point at? Now, over the years, government has invested so much in terms of education. Parents are investing a lot more now. Apart from the normal school system the children go for, some parents are even employing home tuition for their kids. Do you all agree? Yes. I mean, some of you are here, you have home tuition for your kids and additional extra classes. And the students themselves are putting so much effort in studies. But what is happening in terms of the result? A lot more students are failing exams now. At some point, at the junior high school level, the failure rate was 50% consistently for about 5 years, not long ago. In terms of figures, that's 240,000 young people at the junior high school level that are not able to continue with their education. Thank God recently they are introducing this this NOVDEC type of system at the junior high school level so that they can get a second chance. And I think that is a laudable thing. The reason being this: if at that young age you fail an exams and the system makes you believe that you don't deserve a second chance, then the question I want to ask is, where are we going as a country? When we have a lot of young people growing up and they having that mentality that society will not give you a second chance, so you either make it or nobody really cares, then it becomes an issue. Now, even for those who are very confident and are very courageous, let me use the Manchester United example. A lot of people know about Manchester United. Now, they've won a lot of trophies over the years. They've chalked a lot of success over the years. But this season, something funny has happened. The same group of players that have been winning a lot over the years, all of a sudden, they are not winning matches. And they are losing games, and they are somewhere up the table. And what happens? Their confidence has been shattered. Their self-esteem just evaporated away. And that is not just the issue. Manchester United is a global brand. It has affected the brand. Their shares are going down. So you can see something like the issue of having difficulty to remember what you learn as a small problem. But it is bigger than that. Just imagine as a young person, whilst you were growing up, you struggled with studies. I remember sometimes I sit in an exam hall, so I forgot something I want to use to answer a question. But I step out of the exam hall, just step out of the door, and then I remembered after submitting the paper. That is the one you say, Tofiakwa. That's the type of thing that happens and you say, Tofiakwa. You don't want it to happen. Has it happened to anybody here? Oh yes, it happens all the time. So the question is, how does that happen? That an information in your memory that you want to access, it's not accessible at a point. Then 5 minutes just after that point, you can access the information when you don't need it anymore. It was a burden for me because I had a lot of friends who had blackouts in exam situation. He had a blackout and he didn't even write the paper. He failed. He had to write it again. I had friends. I had a friend. She used to work at a commercial bank. She's like a grown-up. Like, she could be my mother. We're in the same class in the university. We went to write this paper, and then when we came out, she was crying like a baby. This is no joke. And she was like, McCarthy, I remembered, when I saw the questions, I remembered I learned these things. But I couldn't retrieve the information from memory to be able to pass the exams. And that's a situation a lot of young people have found themselves in now. And it's a big problem. A big problem because in Ghana, no matter how smart you are, if you are going through the educational system, if you cannot translate whatever you have learned, whatever you have understood, when the examiners, when the WAEC is asking for it, you are not smart. That's just the baseline. That's just the baseline. And it's a problem. Because just look at growing up, being excited about stuff. I mean, doing a lot of fun things when you were younger. Whilst you are growing up through the educational system, you get to a point and now you have to give up every exciting thing you have to do and focus on trying to deal with your problem of not being able to make it in school. So you throw away all the creativity. And then we become very logical beings in our lives. And then we stay away from goals because we are not very sure we can cut it because we have a problem retrieving information from memory. This is what I've been doing over the years. Now, before that, I'll show you this. I was doing some research about memory. But before that, I had a science background, so I knew that the brain, we had a left brain and then the right brain. That the left brain does activities like reading, writing, arithmetic, logic, and similar activities. And then our right brain is involved in activities like daydreaming, color, imagination, creativity, and stuff like that. Now, I came across this research. Dr. Bruno First was just the first doctor to investigate about how memory works from a practical viewpoint. And this is what he found out. That's when we learn. These are some of the techniques we can use when we are putting information to memory. Now, he's saying that we are able to remember just up to 25% of what we put to memory when we read. That's if you adopt the technique of reading. That's how much you can remember. What you hear as I'm talking to you, you're able to remember up to 35% of what you hear more than what you read. And that's what we see with our eyes. We're able to remember up to 50%. So when I was younger, we used to remember what we see on television better than our notebooks when we go to school. Yeah, it was just something that was normal. And then what we say, we're able to remember up to 60%. Why? Let me explain. As I'm talking to you, the information is in my memory, right? As I speak it out to you, I can hear myself speak. So the information actually goes back into my memory to go and strengthen the memory pattern of that information in my head. That is what accounts for the whooping 60% of what we say. Now, the last part has to do with what we do. We're able to remember up to 75%. That's why we have the saying, practice makes what? Perfect. Now, if you combine all these techniques all together, you can remember up to 95% of whatever you want to remember. Now, this is what is happening in our schools. I run workshops. I sit down with students and we discuss learning techniques and I help them to develop and adopt the best techniques. This is what is happening in our schools. Most of young people in our educational system are spending most of their time reading. Most of us reading. So somebody doesn't understand why he reads more and then he's not able to remember. It brings a lot of frustration. Most of the time, that's what we do. We don't tend to do better hearing. The classes are larger. If you went to the proper government school I went to, where they taught us when you see a traffic light, there's something you must know, you know that the classes are larger. So the hearing is an issue. The demonstration is an issue. And you don't get to even rehearse what you learn. So I teach young people how to use these techniques more creatively, especially the other ones. And I can say that for me, in terms of what we do or what we practice, the papers that I did best in school was the ones that I was helping other people to become better. That was the papers that I did best in them. These were papers that I didn't sit down to learn it on my own. I helped my colleagues who were struggling in those papers, and my results were the best. So that was one way of being able to help people to also develop some of these techniques. So this is what I do. I visit schools. I have programs designed for junior high schools. I have programs designed for senior high schools. And I have started from the rural areas. That's where the need is more. As for the cities, we have time to Facebook and Twitter and watch a lot of TV and all that. So we don't really have a problem. It's a choice we have made. But for those in the rural areas who are facing the same problem, they don't get to watch the TV and they don't get to Facebook and all that. And these are young people growing up. For me, I always say, you don't even know where the next Kwame Nkrumah is coming from. You don't know. It could be some boy standing on the street when you step out. You wouldn't know. So what we can do is to try to give everybody the opportunity to be able to live all their dream. So I visited the schools. In 2012, I took time. I had 4 days off from work. And I went to the Volta region. I went to the Anglo State. I visited 7 schools. Had access to over 15,000 young people. I had a lot of fun. This was what I did with them. I do temperament testing with the young people to understand what their behavioral traits are, what their strengths and what their weaknesses are. Because sometimes the behavioral traits you naturally possess can affect your studies. There's somebody who, if you tell the person, go out there, go and buy groundnut 50 pesos, rice 1 CD, and maize 2 pesos, when he gets to the entrance, he has forgotten everything. Naturally, they are forgetful naturally. So how do we help these people? Those are some of the things I do. I sit down with these young people. I teach them the most effective learning techniques that are there that they can use and what they get from these learning techniques. And finally, I also teach people to understand that they can use their natural environment and how the brain responds to things in their environment to learn.